meteorologist Scott Dorval.
And we're back live at Ann Morrison Park, getting ready for the fifth annual fireworks finale or extravaganza going on here at the park. Everything is turning out to be just right so far. Everything's getting real comfortable. The temperatures are cooling nicely. The wind has died down. The crowds are gathering. Generally speaking, this is just about what you'd expect. The crowds are not that big early, but it's really beginning to fill up right now. You see the view from across the park here. Lots of people just relaxing. It's been an amazing day. People coming out here real early. Even before noon, to just kind of relax and just take on just a beautiful day. A tremendous amount of people coming down the river in tubes and rafts and then pouring out at Ann Morrison Park and then just kind of making camp right there. I've seen lots of grills coming over the bridges into Ann Morrison Park. And so a lot of grilling going on here. Some good food being served up at Ann Morrison Park. All right, so what's it going to be like tonight and for the rest of the night? We are less than an hour away from the fireworks, and so it's not that far, and everything's working out just fine. Current conditions, we've got some high clouds here. That dimmed the sun nicely, but the sun now peeking down. Complete shade in Morrison Park now. 86 at the airport, and you notice the wind at 9 miles an hour. That's not the condition at the park. We've already got temperatures here down into the mid-70s, and it'll go down to the lower 70s by the time the fireworks start. The winds are just about calm in the park right now, and that's the way it should stay. Now, there's a fire weather watch in those highlighted areas south of Boise and through the Magic Valley. That's not for tonight or tomorrow. That is for Friday for the chance for some dry lightning to finally move on in, so we may have some fire starts. If we can keep the dry lightning away this year, we may not have a bad fire season, but boy, the fuels are there, and if we get a lot of lightning, it could be trouble. Right now, you'll see those high temperatures in Boise, 90. A beautiful day today, right where it should be. Some folks, 90 is a little too hot, but not bad at all. In the higher elevations, perfect weather. Temperatures in the 70s to near 80 degrees. Redfish Lake today, absolutely picture perfect at 80 degrees this afternoon. All right, let's move on and look at the northwest. There's not much going on at all. See how clear the skies are? But notice what's happening to the south. Clouds developing from monsoon moisture over Vegas and most of Nevada. Those thunderstorms, which are way to the south, will die out overnight, but the debris clouds, the leftover clouds, are the high thin clouds that are already drifting over the Treasure Valley. And overnight tonight, we're going to get a veil of cloud cover, and that will probably keep our temperature pretty mild overnight towards the morning. In the morning hours, you may have high clouds dimming that sun a lot, but then it will disappear, and we'll get those a lot of sunshine coming in a little bit later on. Let's look at the picture now for the forecast for Thursday. Ah, yes, the warming trend begins. Temperatures will start to skyrocket over the next several days. We'll be topping 100 degrees as we head into the weekend. Let's take a look at that forecast now. My on-the-side forecast for the Treasure Valley, we're looking at temperatures, yes, really, really comfortable for folks who like the hot weather. Low to mid-90s tomorrow, 90 to 95 with that sunshine. Hot weather indeed for everybody. Light winds again. High clouds in the morning will be replaced by all that sunshine coming in later in the day. West Central Mountains, look at that. McCall near 80. Close to 90 in Boise County, but real comfortable weather as you get to 5,000 feet if anybody's vacationing. 93 in Riggins on the Maine Salmon. If you're floating the salmon tomorrow, should be nice weather for that as well. 81 in Stanley, 80 in Sun Valley, 82 degrees in Fairfield. And as you look at this on your side extended forecast, after we look at the Magic Valley in the mid-80s, by the way, partly cloudy in the Magic Valley, a little bit of a breeze, but really some pretty typical summer weather moving in. Here's my on your side extended forecast, and look at these temperatures soar. They'll be climbing all right, getting back into the 90s, 94 on Thursday, 97 on Friday. Now remember, there's that threat for some dry lightning coming in, especially in Owyhee County on Friday. And over the weekend, near 100, 99 to 100 Saturday and Sunday. We will probably top 100. We could go to 102. It takes a lot more energy to get those extra degrees when you're above 100, but we could see a 102 or a 103 and some bank thermometers maybe around a 104, say, on Monday. So this is pretty much a heat wave coming in as it stays near 100 right through Wednesday. I hope you've got plans to cool off this weekend because it will be downright hot. Again, we are less than an hour away from the fireworks here at Ed Morrison Park. Everything is working out just as planned. The winds have calmed down. I'd bring some bug spray if you're just walking out the door right now, or you can join us on our sister station today, 6 on your side, at about 10:50, and the fires will go off, and we'll have it all for you with just a great camera shot from all different angles of the fireworks. The crowd is gathering, and over the last 20, 30 minutes, it has really begun to thicken up. So a lot more folks coming in here, and you couldn't ask for better weather. It always seems to be like this, though, when you're coming out here for the 4th of July, and I'm glad we don't have any thunderstorms to deal with. So, Roland, the stage is now set.
And what a stage it is. It's beautiful out there and just picture-perfect weather. Couldn't ask for anything better.
You know, and there's food. The food court's bigger than it was last year. There's music on a stage off in the distance. A couple bands have been playing. So pretty much whatever you want, you can get.
All right, we'll let you get back to having some fun out there, and we'll check in with you again pretty soon. Thanks, Scott.
Okay, Rolla. Well,